وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to speak about دعوة and how to give دعوة. The way that I plan إن شاء الله تعالى to tackle this topic is through three points بإذن الله الكريم. The first point إن شاء الله تعالى is a مقدمة. It's a what? It's a مقدمة, introduction. And in the introduction إن شاء الله تعالى I will speak about the حقيقة and the reality of دعوة. What does دعوة actually mean? And what is its reality? I will do that in my مقدمة. I will do that in my مقدمة, my introduction. The second chapter إن شاء الله تعالى that I will speak about is أصول الدعوة. What are the foundations in which دعوة stands on? I will speak about that بإذن الله الكريم in my second chapter. And last but not least, I will speak about الانحرافات في حقيقة ومفهوم الدعوة. The last part, inshallah ta'ala, I will speak about ways in which people have become deviated and astray from the correct methodology and the correct way of giving da'wah. So those inshallah ta'ala are our inshallah ta'ala topics that we're going to tackle inshallah ta'ala. Da'wah ila Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, da'wah, calling the people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is in its definition and its meaning, according to the ulama and the people of knowledge, is as-sa'yu, is to strive, لِنَشْرِ دِينِ اللَّهِ, to spread the religion of Allah ta'ala, عَقِيدَةً وَشَرِيعَةً وَأَخْلَاقًا وَبَذْلُ الْوُسْعِ فِي ذَلِكَ. A da'wah is to spread the religion of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, عَقِيدَةً, in terms of its عقيدة, its creedal beliefs, وَأَخْلَاقًا, in terms of its etiquettes and manners, وَبَذْلِ الْوُسْعِ فِي ذَلِكَ, and it is to exert every effort which you have and every ability which a person has. That's what da'wah means in a very simple observation. The second point that I want to speak about is da'wah a qadiyya manhajiyya? Is it a aqidah related issue or is it a qadiyya fiqhiyya, a fiqh related issue? And the reason why the question should be clear at the beginning is that if you say that aqidah is a fiqh related issue, you might then say after that, the reason why it's a fiqh related issue is because you have the right to do as you wish. But if it is aqidah related, you may say that it is tawqifi, meaning you're not allowed to do anything unless you have textual evidence for it. But what I want to say is, الدعوة إلى الله تعالى, calling the people to Allah, is a قضية عقدية منهجية. It's a aqidah related issue, وليست قضية فقهية. And it is not a fiqhi issue. And what we also have to understand is, who said that if something is a fiqhi issue, you're also allowed to do as you wish? Even the masail which are fiqhiyya, that oppose in fiqh issues, there are some issues when it opposes the Quran and the Sunnah and the Ijma', the scholars, they don't accept it from the person in differing with them in this issue. If a mas'ala goes against a nas, which is Kitab and Sunnah, wal Ijma', and it goes against the Ijma', it is not tolerated in differing with this issue. It's not tolerated. ولذلك الإمام البخاري رحمه الله in his Sahih he chapter a bab and he called it باب ما يذكر من ذم الرأي والتكلف القياس. الإمام البخاري said rebuking the الرأي opinion وتكلف القياس and using analogy. And he brought the ayah ولا تقف. And Bukhari said أي لا تقل, don't say ما ليس لك به علم, that which you have no knowledge for. So he brought the ayah ولا تقف ما ليس لك به علم. He says باب ما يذكر من ذم الرأي والتكلف القياس ولا تقف لا تقل ما ليس لك به ما ليس لك به علم, that which you have no knowledge of. And then right after that, Bukhari رحمه الله, under that chapter he brought the hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As رضي الله تعالى عنهما, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, that he said, I heard the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم say, إن الله لا ينزع العلم بعد أن أعطاهموه انتزاعا ولكن ينتزعه منهم مع قبض العلماء بعلمهم فيبقى ناس جهال يستفتون فيفتون برأيهم فيضلون ويضلون فيضلون ويضلون. الإمام البخاري who brought the hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As that the Prophet said Allah does not take knowledge which he gave you, and he doesn't just take it like that, but the way Allah takes knowledge is what? ولكن ينتزعه منهم مع قبض العلماء بعلمهم. The way Allah takes it is by taking the people of knowledge. فَيَبْقَى نَاسٌ جُهَالٌ. When Allah takes the scholars, there remains ignorant individuals. فَيُفْتُونَ بِرَأِيهِمْ. They give verdicts based upon their opinions. فَيُضِلُّونَ. So they misguide themselves. فَيُضِلُّونَ. So they misguide others. وَيُضِلُّونَ. And they misguide themselves. So what does the Imam al-Bukhari want to use from this hadith? He wants to use from it that it says, فَيُفْتُونَ بِرَأِيهِمْ. They give verdicts based upon their opinions. So masail fiqhiyya, if they are based upon opinions, and they are opposing the nas and the ijma', it's rebuked, and it's spoken against. And Abi Wa'ilin, he said, سَهْلِ بْنُ حُنَيِّفٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O people, اِتَّهِمُ رَأْيَكُمْ عَلَى دِينِكُمْ. Suspect your opinions upon the religion. Have suspicion of your opinion over the textual evidences. Ibn Shihab, أن عمر بن الخطاب إلى عمر, he was upon the pulpit one day, and he said to the people, يا أيها الناس, O people, إن الرأي إنما كان من رسول الله مصيبا. رأي from the Prophet was correct. He was doing it right. لأن الله عز وجل كان يريه, because Allah was showing the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم what he should say and what he shouldn't say. إنما هو من الظن والتكلف. But from us, it's based upon speculation and assumption. And Imam al-Bayhaqi rahimahullah, what did he say? In his Sunan al-Kubra, he says, وَإِنَّمَا أَرَادَ بِهِ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ الرَّأْيَ الَّذِي لَا يَكُونُ مُشْتَبَهًا مُشَبَّهًا بِأَصْلٍ. That Imam al-Bayhaqi said that Umar's statement means here that it's the opinion that has not rooted and is not grounded from an asal. It's not coming from the Qur'an or the Sunnah. So masail al-fiqhiyya, if they oppose the Qur'an and the Sunnah, and they are not in line of the Qur'an and the Sunnah, it's also rebuked. Umar ibn Khattab also said, إِيَّاكُمْ وَأَصْحَابَ الرَّأِيِ. Stay away from the people of opinions. فَإِنَّهُمْ أَعْدَاءُ السُنَنِ. They are the enemies of the Sunnah, the textual evidences. أَعْيَتْهُمُ الْأَحَادِيثُ. The ahadith, they became unable to go to the ahadith and take from the Qur'an and the Sunnah. They weren't able to do that. And they were unable to memorize it. أَعْيَتْهُمُ الْأَحَادِيثُ وَأَنْ يَحْفَظُوهَا. They couldn't memorize the ahadith. فَقَالُوا بِالرَّأِي فَضَلُّوا وَأَضَلُّوا. So they couldn't memorize it, so they said, they spoke with opinions, I think. So they misguided themselves and they misguided others. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, لَيْسَ عَامٌ إِلَّا وَالَّذِي بَعْدَهُ شَرٌّ مِنْهُ. That there is no year except the year after is worse. لا أقول, I'm not going to say to you, عام أمطر من عام, that a year has more rain than another year. ولا عام أخصب من عام, that another year has more greenery than another year. ولا أمير خير من أمير, and I won't say to you that a leader is better than another leader. ولكن, but what I mean by my statement that a year will not come except the year after is worse, what I mean by that is, ولكن ذهاب خياركم وعلمائكم. Your smart, your well-educated, and your scholars will all go. ثُمَّ يَحْدُثُ قَوْمٌ يَقِيسُونَ الْأُمُورَ بِرَأْيِهِمْ. And then will come a people who will base everything upon their opinions. فَيُهْدَمُ الْإِسْلَامُ وَيُثْلَمُ. And then Islam becomes destroyed based on that. So we know that opinions and in matters of fiqh are like that. Also, Awf ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet said, تَفْتَرِقُ أُمَّتِي عَلَى بِضْعٍ وَسَبْعِينَ فِرْقَةٍ. Awf ibn Malik, he said that the Prophet said that my ummah will be divided into 70 and something. أَعْظَمُهَا فِتْنَةً عَلَى أُمَّتِي قَوْمٌ يَقِيسُونَ الْأُمُورَ بِرَأَيِّهِمْ. The greatest fitna for my ummah is a people. يَقِيسُونَ الْأُمُورَ, they will weigh and scale matters based upon their opinions. فَيُحِلُّونَ الْحَرَامَ, and so they will make the haram halal. وَيُحَرِّمُونَ الْحَلَالَ, and they will make the halal haram. All based upon what? Based upon ra'y and opinion. These are masail fiqhiyya. So even if da'wah is a masala fiqhiyya, if it goes against the kitab and the sunnah, if it goes against the nas, which is the textual evidence, the kitab and the sunnah, or it goes against ijma', this is how we'll deal with it. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, وَفِي ذَمِّ الرَّأِي آثَارٌ مَشْهُورَةٌ عَنْ عُمَرَ وَعُثْمَانَ وَعَلِيٍّ وَابْنُ عَبَّاسٍ وَابْنُ عُمَرَ وَغَيْرِهِمْ وَكَذَلِكَ عَنِ التَّابِعِينَ بَعْدَهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ فِي بَيَانِ أَنَّ الْأَخْذَ بِالرَّأِي يُحَلِّلُ الْحَرَامَ وَيُحَرِّمُ الْحَلَالَ وَمَعْلُومٌ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْآثَارَ الذَّامَّةَ لِلرَّأِي لَمْ يُقْصَدْ بِهَا اجْتِهَادُ الرَّأِي عَلَى الْأُصُولِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ وَالْإِجْمَاعِ فِي حَادِثَةٍ لَمْ تُوجَدْ فِي كِتَابٍ وَلَا سُنَّةٍ وَلَا إِجْمَاعٍ مِمَّنْ يَعْرِفُ الْأَشْبَاهَ وَالنَّظَائِرَ وَفِقْهَ مَعَانِي الْأَحْكَامِ فَيَقِيسُ قِيَاسَ تَشْبِيهٍ وَتَمْثِيلٍ أَوْ قِيَاسَ تَعْلِيلٍ وَتَأْصِيلٍ قِيَاسًا لَمْ يُعَارِضْ مَا هُوَ أَوْلَى مِنْهُ. الإمام ابن تيمية, he expands on the point that I mentioned, which is that there have come textual evidences from Umar, Uthman, Ali, Ibn Abbas, Ibn Umar, and other than them, rebuking opinions, rebuking and speaking about it. Also Tabi'een, and those who came after them, speaking about what? Taking opinions and saying this is halal, which is haram, and saying which is haram, which is that which is halal. All of that which is what? And they're all what? Masail what? قضية فقهية. So even if we accept the idea that الدعوة إلى الله تعالى is قضية فقهية, who said to you every مسألة فقهية, every issue pertaining to fiqh is من المسائل الاجتهادية? Who said that to you? In which you do اجتهاد on. Not to mention الدعوة إلى الله تعالى is a matter which is what? قضية منهجية عقدية. It's not a fiqh issue أصلا. And even if it was, then we said to you, not every issue which is fiqhiyya is what? Is from the masail which are ijtihadiyya. They are not from masail ijtihadiyya. So manhajul da'wah and the means for da'wah are all tawqifiyya. We would have to withhold. This is the verdict of Ibn Baz, rahimahullah. And it's also the verdict of Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah. And the verdict of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih Al-Uthaymeen. And also the verdict of who? Sheikh Salih Al-Fawzan. Al-Fawzan. حفظه الله تعالى. That's the verdict that they gave. So what does it mean when we say that da'wah is a قضية منهجية عقدية? What do we mean by that? It means أنه لا يجوز, it is not permissible. إحداث منهج دعوي غير ما جاءت به النصوص. You're not allowed to initiate a methodology and a way in da'wah that has not come with any textual evidences. For example, فلا يدعى إلا إلى التوحيد والسنة. You're not allowed to call to accept the kitab. You're only allowed to call to what? إلى التوحيد والسنة والبدء بذلك. And you have to what? Start with those two. And how do you do your spreading of the deen? وعلى طريقة السلف, the way that the pious predecessors did it. ولزوم السمع والطاعة للأئمة, and that you're in line with the Muslim leader who's governing over you. ولزوم الجماعة, and that you stay within the جماعة المسلمين. All these means that have been introduced, you stay away from them and you don't do them. For example, you do not start your da'wah with fada'ilul a'mal, righteous deeds. You don't base your da'wah upon a what? As-sa'yu ila al-hukmi, to reaching leadership and political issues. Aw al-tajmi' wa al-tahzib wa takthir al-atba'. And you also don't base your da'wah upon what? Grouping and sectarianism and organization and gathering knowledge, gathering groups and numbers. As it's also not what? It is also not permissible to use means that are haram in the Sharia, for example, to lie for the purpose of da'wah, or to use music instruments, which now some call anashid islamiyya, to use that as your form of da'wah. You're not allowed to do that. You're not also allowed to use going against the Muslim leaders as a form of da'wah. What is also not allowed is using al-mudaharat wal-i'tisamat, protesting and uprising against leaders and also protesting. It's also not permissible. Also in making ahzab tanzimat sirriya, hidden private groups that speak behind closed doors, like Hizb al-Tahrir and Ikhwan al-Muslimin and al-Tabligh and groups like that, who are ahzab wa tanzimat sirriya. All of those are not permissible. What is also not allowed to be used is that which has no textual evidence. Those which have no, they have no textual evidences. Ad-da'watu ila Allah ta'ala, calling to the way of Allah, as we said, it's what? At-tawqifiyyah. The Quran and the Sunnah have set it. Allah says in the Quran, ud'u ila sabili rabbika, call to the way of your Lord, bil hikmah, with wisdom, wal maw'idhati al-hasana, and call with it based upon wisdom. وَجَادِلْهُمْ and debate with them بِالَّتِي هِي أَحْسَنِ in the best ways. Allah even told us, the Prophet ﷺ told us in the hadith, how to do that. He said, مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا, if any one of you see evil, فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِي, stop it with your hand, فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِلِسَانِهِ with your tongue, فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِقَلْبِهِ with his heart, وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. And that is the weakest and the lowest of iman. So you've been told how to stop a munkar and an evil which you're doing. How can somebody say that ad-da'watu ila Allah, according to Allah's way, it's not a what? It is not tawqifiyyah, that it's not based upon finding textual evidence for it, and without it you're not allowed to do that means or that way. Why would somebody say that when every messenger that was sent, Allah sent them subhanahu wa ta'ala with a way to give da'wah? Let's look at the Quran. Allah says, Ya ayyuha an-nabiy, O messenger of Allah, inna arsalnaka, we have sent you, shahidan, a witness, wa mubashiran, one who gives glad tidings, wa nadhiran, one who warns, wa da'iyan, calling to what? Ila Allahi, to your Lord, bi idnihi, with his permission, wa sirajan munira, and you're doing it with what? A guided way. Allah also says, ud'u ila sabili rabbika, call to the way of your Lord, bil hikmah, with wisdom, wal maw'idha, with a reminder, al hasana, wa jadilhum, argue with them in that which is good. Allah also said to the Prophet, ula'ika alladhina hada Allah, those people, those prophets, Allah guided them, fabihudahum muqtadi, follow their path in da'wah. Allah also said to the Prophet, say to them, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, I call to my, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, this is my path. أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, I call to Allah. عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ, I call to him with wisdom, insight and knowledge. أَنَا, I do that. وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي, and those who follow me. Follow him in what? In da'wah. وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ, exalted as Allah. وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, and I am not from those who are disbelievers. Allah also said, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ, and this is my path, follow it. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ, do not follow the paths. فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِي, will then take you away from the path Allah sent. إِذَنْ, da'wah has what? سَبِيل, a path. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي, this is my path. Path in what? In da'wah, in action, in belief, in everything. Da'wah has a path. And then Allah ta'ala then says to you, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ, Allah told us there are other people who have other paths and other ways in which they call to Allah. We should not follow them in that path. Allah also says to us in another ayah, كُنْتُمْ, you guys are, خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ, the best of nations. Doing what lakin? تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, you call to the good. How would I know what is good and what is bad? I have to have knowledge. It then it's a path. وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and you prohibit evil. وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ, and you believe in Allah. Allah also says subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِينَ, the ones, إِن مَكَّنَّاهُمْ, that we make them governors over this world. أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ, they establish the prayer. وَآتَوُوا الزَّكَاةِ, and they give zakat. وَأَمَرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, they call to good. وَنَهَوْا عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and they prohibit evil. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, وَتَعَاوَنُوا, aid one another. In what? لَكِنْ عَلَى الْبِرِّ, what is birr? وَالتَّقْوَى, what is taqwa? That's what we're meant to help each other with. All of this requires knowledge and understanding, and having knowledge of that path. Allah then says, وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا, and don't help each other. عَلَى الْإِثْمِ, on evil. وَالْعُدْوَانَ, and transgression. And what is ithm and what is udwan? The person needs to know that. Allah also says in another ayah, لَا خَيْرَ فِي كَثِيرٍ مِّن نَجْوَاهُمْ, many people's discussion and their talks, there's no khayr in it. إِلَّا مَنْ أَمَرَ بِصَدَقَةٍ, except the person who commands the people what? الصَّدَقَة. He commands the people what? As-sadaqah. And the sadaqah is two types. Sadaqah maliyah, where the person has to give money. And there's another type of sadaqah, sadaqah ghayra maliyah. Sadaqah ghayra maliyah, which is that you don't have to give, you don't have to give money. What's the evidence for that? The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kullu sulama min al-nasi alayhi sadaq, kullu sulam. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور يصلون كما نصلي ويصومون كما نصوم ويتصدقون بفضول أموالهم. And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أليس لكم, is it not for you that which you can give is sadaqah, which is what? At-tasbih, wa-takbir, wa-tahmid, wa-tahleel, wa-fi budu'i hadikum sadaqah. All of those are what? Sadaqah ghayra maliyah. The Prophet said, alayhi salakum ma tasaddaqoon. Do you not have that which you can give is sadaqah? So all of those are what? Sadaqah ghayra maliyah. And then when you're calling the people to, you're calling them to what? La ghayra fi kathiri min najwahum illa man amara bi sadaqah. The sadaqah that you're calling the people to is sadaqah maliyah. But you have to know the nisab. You have to know the hawl. You have to know what zakat and its ahkam. What are you going to call the people if you don't know it? And how are you going to call the people to the sadaqah ghayra maliyah if you don't understand it and you don't have a perception of it? أو معروف, you call the people to good. أو إصلاح بين الناس, to bring good between the people. ومن يفعل ذلك, anyone who does that, ابتغاء مرضات الله, doing it all for the sake of who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, فسوف نؤتيه أجرا عظيما, we're going to give them a lot of reward. Also Allah says to the Prophet, يا أيها النبي, O Messenger of Allah, جاهد الكفار, fight with the disbelievers, والمنافقين, and the hypocrites, وغلظ عليهم, and be harsh on them. Also Allah, he's been told what to do and how to do it, and the methodology he needs to do it. وغلظ عليهم, it's a methodology. Allah says to him about, Allah also says, فلا تطع المكذبين, Muhammad, don't obey the liars and those who are lying. ودوا لو تدهنوا فيدهنون, they want you to become soft and they want you to weaken down your religion so then they can come towards your direction. He's been told, don't do that. Don't do mudahana. Also Allah says to the Prophet, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. If it wasn't for the mercy of Allah that you were soft for them, وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ, and if you were a person who's hard, his heart is hard, لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ, they would leave your gathering. فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ, ask forgiveness for them. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ, forgive them and ask forgiveness for them. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ, consult them. He's being told how to give da'wah and what to do and what he shouldn't do. Shows you what? The Prophet wasn't left to come himself عليه الصلاة والسلام and choose the way he wants to give da'wah. Allah also said to the Prophet, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ, obey Allah, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ, obey the messenger, وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ, and those who have authority upon you. فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ, if you dispute one another, فِي شَيْءٍ مَاتَ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَحْسَنُ تَأْوِيلًا. Also Allah said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. Also Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, فلا تكونن ظهيرا للكافرين ولا يصدنك ولا يصدنك عن آيات الله بعد إذ أنزلت إليك وادع إلى ربك ولا تكونن من المشركين. All of those ayat, what did they show you? All of those nusus, they show you that the messengers and the prophets and Nabiullah Muhammad were all being told how to give da'wah. And then da'wah is a what? It's tawqifiyya. ما معنى tawqifiyya? You have to take it from the kitab and the sunnah. Just like the Prophet took it from who? All through the 23 years of his life, what was he being told? Do this, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this. That shows you, at-tariqu, at-tariqu al-da'wa is what? It is marsoom. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said, أنه لما قال, لما بعث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم معاذا نحو لليمن. The Prophet sent Mu'adh to Yemen, and he said to him, إِنَّكَ تَقْدُمُ عَلَى قَوْمٍ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. Mu'adh, you're going to come to a people of, the people of the scripture. Again, the Prophet is giving him the way to give da'wah, which is what? Mura'at muqtada al-mukhatab. The people you're going to be addressing and the people you're going to be talking are not ignorant people. They are not what? They're not ignorant. They have scripture. They have a book they follow. So it's giving him the understanding of who he's going to deal with. A da'i needs to know that. Are you talking to a scholar? Are you talking to a ami? Are you talking to a mujrim? Are you talking to a person whose heart is close? The people that you're talking to know who they are. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, udu ila sabila rabbika bil hikma wal maw'idatil hasana wajadilhum billati hi ahsan. These are the types of people that you're talking to. Each person, you speak to them in a particular way. So the Prophet said to Mu'adh, you're going to come to a people. And he didn't say to him, do as you wish and call to what you want and whatever you find fit, do it. He didn't say that. He said, falyakun, let it be. He set him a guideline to follow to show you that da'wah is what? It's a tariqah marsuma. It's a path that's written and it's paved and it's set. فَلْيَكُنْ أَوَّلَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَنْ يُوَحِدُوا اللَّهَ. Let the first thing you call them to be what? Let the first thing you call them to what? Let the first thing you call them to be what? To worship Allah alone and not to associate partners with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then today we have a group of people whose da'wah starts with what? Al-fada'ilu a'mal. You know, just don't talk to people about that. This disunites the people. It breaks the sufuf of the people. We shouldn't speak about these issues. What should we do? Let's talk about giving charity and sadaqah and whatnot. هذا مخالف مخالف للنص. It's in opposition to the text. That is what? It's in opposition to what? It's an opposition to the text. It's going against the nusus. Another group of people, their da'wah is based upon what? As-sa'yu ila al-hukm. Striving to leadership. Striving to become in charge of matters. That's what they're running to. Another group of people, their da'wah is based upon what? The first minute they meet you, don't take knowledge from fulan and allan. That's their da'wah. The first thing it starts, that's what they teach the people. Like in the person of the sunnah, what does he do? فَلْيَكُنْ أَوَّلَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَن يُوَحِّدُوا اللَّهَ تَعَالَىٰ فَإِذَا عَرَفُوا ذَلِكَ. If the person, the Prophet said, once they agree to that and they acknowledge that, فَأَخْبِرْهُمْ, then tell them, أَنَّ اللَّهَ فَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ خَمْسَ صَلَوَاتٍ فِي يَوْمِهِمْ وَلَيْلَتِهِمْ. Five prayers that are needed from them in the day and in the night. فَإِذَا صَلُّوا, if they pray then, فَأَخْبِرْهُمْ, then tell them, أَنَّ اللَّهَ فَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ زَكَاةً, that Allah is going to take it from them, zakat. فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ تُؤْخَذُ مِنْ غَنِيِّهِمْ فَتُرَدُّ عَلَى فَقِيرِهِمْ, is taken from the rich and is given to the poor. فَإِذَا قَرُّوا بِذَلِكَ, if they then accept that, فَخُذْ مِنْهُمْ وَتَوَقِّ كَرَائِمَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ. If they do that and they accept that, then take it from them, take their wealth from them, and don't take the best of their wealth. Like, take what's middle. Don't take their best of wealth. The Prophet is sending Mu'adh and he's sending him a guideline, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then what we say is, فَالدَّعْوَةُ قَدْ رَسَمَهُ قَدْ رَسَمَ طَرِيقَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. Prophets have set the path for da'wah, alayhim as-salatu wasalam. And that's the salaful madhul, salaful salihul madhul, our pious predecessors from the sahabas and the tabi'een and the tabi'u tabi'een, radiyallahu ajma'een, may Allah be pleased with all of them. All of them, that's the path that they tread on. And walidhalik al-imam Malik rahimahullah, he said, la yasluhu akhir hadhihi al-ummah illa bima salaha bihi awwaluha, fama lam yakun yawma idin deenan la yakunu al-yawma deena. That which the early generation did not find prosperity and success in, the late generation will not find prosperity and success in it. And that which wasn't a religion that day will not become a religion today. So we now left the muqaddimah, the introduction, where we spoke about what does da'wah mean and what's the reality of da'wah. We spoke about it. We're now going to move on to the second chapter that we want to speak about, which is usul al-da'wah. Usul al-da'wah, which is the foundations which da'wah stands on. We're going to take it from one ayah, inshaAllah ta'ala. This ayah is the most comprehensive verse that gives you the foundations and the principles in which da'wah stands on. And it's the statement of Allah where He says, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, this is my path. أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, I call to Allah. عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ, I call to with insight. I do that. وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي, and those who follow me, they do that. Subhanallah, subhanallah, exalted is Allah. وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, and I am not from the pagans and the polytheists. This ayah has set and it has mentioned أصول الدعوة, the foundations of da'wah, which is number one, al-ghayatu min al-da'wah. What's the ultimate goal from da'wah? What is the objective of da'wah? And the second thing that this ayah has spoken about is tariqu al-da'wati wa sabiluha, the path for da'wah and the way which da'wah is done. And the third one, which is awsafu al-da'i wa al-salik li tariqi al-da'wah, the description and the characteristics and the attributes of the individual who's giving da'wah. We're going to stand over each one in details. What is the ghaya min al-da'wah? The ghaya from da'wah, in quick summary, is at-tahqiq al-ubudiyyati lillahi ta'ala wahdahu wa tanzihuhu an al-shirki. The ghaya, the ultimate goal for da'wah is what? Is Allah to be worshipped, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we're calling the people to. Our da'wah shouldn't be calling the people to our masjid, our organization, our names, our titles, our. But what is it that we call the people to? We call the people to al-ubudiyyati lillah, that we make them slaves of Allah, that they worship Him alone, and they do not associate partners with Him, and that they stay away from shirk. Where does that say in the ayah? It says, ad'u ila Allah, I call to Allah. And then the last part is what? Wa tanzihu an shirki is the last part of the ayah, wa subhanallahi wa ma ana min al-mushrikeen. So you call to Tawheed and you call against a shirk. That's what the ayah mentioned. And that's the ultimate goal of da'wah, which is to call the people to what? Ilallahi, to Allah. And also to warn them against what? Ash-shirku. The ayah mentioned that. The second one, which is tariqu da'wah, the way in which da'wah is given, and the methodology for da'wah is following the prophets. Okay? And especially our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the ayah mentioned this, which is هذه سبيلي, this is my path. And also when it says, Ana, my path, وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي, and those who follow me. And the ayah also mentioned the description of the da'i, and he mentioned two things. Al-ikhlasu lillah, sincerity for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's sake, which is what? Ad'u ila Allah, I call to Allah. I'm doing this for him subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one else. And the second characteristic that he gives is what? Al-ilmu shar'i. He has the knowledge of the religion, which is ala basiratin, insight of the deen. Then let's stand over each one. Al-asl al-awwal, the first asl which is in the, that's in the ayah, which is what? تحقيق العبودية لله تعالى وحده وتنزيه عن الشرك. Calling to Allah alone and warning against what? الشرك. Allah said in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ, that we have sent every prophet, every nation we have sent a prophet to them, which is, what is his job? أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ, that Allah is worship. وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ, and stay away from what? الطَّاغُوتَ. And طَاغُوتَ is what? كُلُّ مَا عُبِدَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ رَاضٍ, everything that is worshipped besides Allah and he is pleased with being worshipped besides Allah, this individual is what? Is a طاغوت. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he told us in another ayah, فَإِنْ أَعْرَضُوا فَقُلْ أَنذَرْتُكُمْ صَاعِقَةً مِثْلَ صَاعِقَةِ عَادٍ وَثَمُودَ إِذْ جَاءَتْهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ إِذْ جَاءَتْهُمُ الرُّسُلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Messengers came to them. إِذْ جَاءَتْهُمُ الرُّسُلُ, the messengers, they came to them. مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ, from in front of them. وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ, from behind. What was it that they said? أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. No one should be worshipped except Allah. This is all the Rusul. Allah says in another ayah, وَاذْكُرْ أَخَا عَادٍ إِذْ أَنذَرَ قَوْمَهُ بِالْأَحْقَافِ وَقَدْ خَلَتِ النُّذُرُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهَ. That's what they said. وَقَدْ خَلَتِ النُّذُرُ, warnings came, مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ, prophets came before them and after them. All of the prophets, what were they saying? أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهَ, only Allah should be worshipped subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another ayah Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ, we have not sent before you, O Muhammad, مِنْ رَسُولٍ, a messenger, إِلَّا نُوحِي, except the revelation we sent on him, which was what? لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ, that there is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah said in another ayah, وَمَا أُمِرُوا, they were not commanded, every nation, this is the thing that they were commanded, which is what? إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ, except to worship Allah. In what state? مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ, sincerely for his sake subhanahu wa ta'ala. حُنَفَى, deviated from shirk. وَيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ, and that they establish the prayer. وَيُؤْتِ الزَّكَاةَ, and they give zakat. وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةَ, and that's the upright religion. Also Allah said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَّثِرُ, O Prophet, the one who is shrouding himself, covering him, قُمْ, stand up. فَأَنذِرْ, call and warn. وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ, and what? Do takbir of your Lord. قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ means warn against shirk. وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ means what? Come call to tawheed. وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَحِّرْ means what? Rectify and purify either your action or your clothes or your heart. Both three meanings are in there. وَالرُّجِزَ فَهْجُرْ, and stay away from filth. So the Prophet ﷺ, what was the first thing he was commanded? قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ, stand up and warn. Warn against what? الشِّرْكُ. وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ means what? Your Lord, call to his oneness and that he should be worshipped alone. Amr ibn Absata al-Sulamiyu radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the hadith is collected in Sahih Muslim. He said, كُنْتُ أَنَا فِي الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ, I was upon jahiliyyah. أَظُنُّ أَنَّ النَّاسَ عَلَى ضَلَالَتِ, and I believe that the people are upon misguidance. This was before the prophets came. He said, I was in jahiliyyah and I believe that the people are misguided. وَأَنَّهُمْ لَيْسُوا عَلَى شَيْءٍ, and that the people are upon nothing. وَهُمْ يَعْبُدُونَ الْأَوْثَانَ, whilst they worship in idols. فَسَمِعْتُ بِرَجُلٍ, then I heard of a man, بِمَكَّةَ, a man in Mecca, يُخْبِرُ أَخْبَارًا, he's saying things, he's informing us of things. فَقَعَدْتُ عَلَى رَاحِلَتِي, he said, I mounted on my riding beast. فَقَدِمْتُ عَلَيْهِ, I came to him. فَإِذَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, it was the Prophet of Allah, مُسْتَخْفِيًا, the Prophet was hiding himself. فَتَلَطَّفْتُ حَتَى دَخَلْتُ عَلَيْهِ بِمَكَّةِ, he said, I came and I entered onto him. فَقُلْتُ, I then said to him, مَنْ أَنْتَ, قال, I said to him, مَا أَنْتَ, what are you? قال, أنا النبي, he said, I'm a prophet. The prophet said this, I'm a prophet. فَقُلْتُ, I then said to him, وَمَا نَبِيٌ, what's a prophet? قال, أَرْسَلَنِي اللَّهِ, أَرْسَلَنِي اللَّهِ, Allah has sent me out subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقُلْتُ, I then said to him, وَبِأَيِّ شَيْءٍ أَرْسَلَكَ, what is it that he sent you out with? قال, أَرْسَلَنِي بِصِلَةِ الْأَرْحَامِ, he sent me out with what? keeping the ties of kinship. وَكَسْرِ الْأَوْثَانِ to destroy the idols. وَأَنْ يُوَحَّدَ اللَّهِ and that Allah is what? And that Allah تبارك وتعالى is worshipped alone. لَا يُشْرَكُ بِهِ شَيْءٌ and that He's not associated partners with Him. That's what I was sent with. Either brothers and sisters who are listening. فَالدَّعْوَةُ كُلُّهَا تَدُورُ حَوْلَ تَحَقِيقِ هَذِي الْغَايَةِ Da'wah revolves around in its ultimate meaning and in everything. What does it revolve around? تَحَقِيقُ هَذِي الْغَايَةِ to fulfill this ultimate goal. Which is what? الدَّعْوَةُ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى is that is the people call to Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala and not to associate partners with Him. الأصل الثاني the second أصل which is what? طَرِيقُ الدَّعْوَةِ وَسَبِيلُهَا the way that da'wah is done and its methodology and its path. What is it? وَاتِّبَاعُ الْأَنْبِيَاء it's to follow the prophets and it's to follow who? The messengers. Especially our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the ayah said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say to the people, هذه سبيلي, this is my path. What does that show us, brothers? That the way that da'wah is done is what? And its methodology is tawqifiyul muhaddadul la yajuzu tajawuzu. That it's set and it's placed and it's not permissible for you to exceed it. Question here is, هذه is ism ishara. In the Arabic language, an ism ishara either goes back to one of two things. Either which shay, which is mahsus, a tangible thing, or it goes back to something which is ma'anawi, something which is not tangible. And what is it that it goes back to? It goes back to the whole of the story of Surah Yusuf. هذه سبيلي, this is my path. So the story of Nabila Yusuf's story, it tells us, because this is Surah Yusuf, what does it tell us? Everything in which Yusuf did is the path that the Prophet ﷺ was set to do as well. And remember when Nabilah Yusuf was in the what? When he was in the prison. And then they asked him, they said to him that we had a dream. And we want you to tell us the interpretation of the dream. What did he say to them? Before he answered the question that they asked, what did he say to them? أَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ خَيْرٌ أَمِ اللَّهُ أَمِ اللَّهُ الْوَحِدُ الْقَهَارُ He didn't respond to their dream. And he didn't tell them what the answer to their dream was. But that was the first thing he said to them. Are you going to worship besides Allah tabarak wa ta'ala? The reason is because the first thing you need to start with in your da'wah is what? At-tawheed. The oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Yusuf did not want to mention anything other than that. And the Prophet was then said to him, هذه سبيلي, this is my path. Everything he did. Al-amru bit-tawheed. Yusuf called to tawheed. والصبر على الدعوة. And his patience in his da'wah. والعفو والصفح عن المسيء. How he forgave and he forgot about those who wronged him and did wrong to him. وَاجْتِنَابُ الْمَعَاصِي How he stayed away from the sins as a da'i. The way he stayed away from the sin. Okay? And other than that, he stayed away from the zina. And he stood away from that. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Then that's the path in which the Prophet ﷺ, it became obligatory for him to follow. And everyone who takes his path. And what is it that we need to start with in our da'wah? Al-bada'atu bima bada'a bihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We need to start with what the Prophet started with. Wa taqdimu ma qaddama. And we need to bring forward that which he brought forward. Wa ta'khiru ma akhara. And anything he delayed, we delay. We use the harshness in which he used in the places that he used it in. And we use softness and tenderness in the places he used it in alayhi salatu wa sallam. We also take what? We also follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The way we deal with the people and the way we deal with their situation. We follow the Prophet in it, alayhi salatu wasalam. Knowing the rights of everybody. Knowing the rights of what? Every single body. How the Prophet set it to them. We know it. We know how Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, what rights He gave the leaders. And we give them their rights in the things that He told us and the way to do it. And we deal with the alim in the way Allah told us to deal with him. We deal with the jahil and the ignorant the way Allah and His Messenger told us to deal with him. We deal with the woman in the way Allah and His Messenger told us to deal with them. We deal with the man in the way Allah and His Messenger told us to deal with him. We deal with the young one the way Allah and His Messenger told us to deal with the young one. And the Muslim and the disbeliever and the Sunni who's upon the Sunnah. The Mubtadi' the way Allah and His Messenger told us to deal with them. The one who's obedient of Allah the way we should deal with him. And the one who's sinner the way we should deal with them. All of them. They have طرق التعامل, a methodology and a way that we deal with them when we're giving da'wah. All of this is what? It's marsoom, it's set. When you're talking to the ra'iyyah, the people, you don't speak to them the way you speak to the leader. The Prophet made a different way for him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Sahih? The Prophet set a way for the leader, and the Muslim leader, the way he's dealt with them. Also, the Prophet ﷺ set a way that we should deal with the scholars. Allah, the way to deal with the wife, and the way to deal with the mother and the daughter, and the way to deal with your husband, and the way to deal with every single body, there is a way to deal with them when you're giving da'wah. And you have to follow that path. The third asal, which is what? Awsafu da'i wa saliki li tariqi da'wah. The way in which the da'i should be when he's giving da'wah. Awwaluha, the first one is ikhlas. Sincere. Allah says in the ayah, wad'u ila rabbik, call to your Lord, innaka la'ala huda mustaqim. In another ayah, Allah said, wad'u ila rabbik, wa la takunanna minal mushrikeen. Call to your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah says in another ayah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. The person doesn't intend from his da'wah what? فَلَا يَقْصِدُ جَاهًا أَوْ مَنْزِلَةً أَوْ مَالًا. The person doesn't intend wealth, reputation, position. Doesn't want any of that. وَلَا يَقْصِدُ, and his intent in da'wah is not to what? To make a great large number of followers. How many people are following me? Has my number reduced? That's not his intention. It shouldn't be the intention of the da'i. The second characteristics of the da'i is what? Al-basira, wa hiya al-ilmu shar'i. That he has insight and he has knowledge. Ya ikhwa, fal-ulama' humu du'at. The scholars are the du'at. Because why? لأن العلماء ورثة الأنبياء. They're the ones who inherited the Prophet in this position. Who are the ones who took the Prophet's position? Who is the greatest da'i? Nabiullah Muhammad. Who is the one who takes his position in giving da'wah? The ulama, the people of knowledge. Abi Darda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, what did he say? He said, I heard the Prophet ﷺ say, إِنَّ الْعُلَمَاءُ وَرَثَةُ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ, that the scholars are the ones who inherited the Prophet. What is it that they inherited from the Prophet? They inherited da'wah, this position. إِنَّ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ لَمْ يُوَرِّثُوا دِينَارًا وَلَا دِرْهَمًا إِنَّمَا وَرَّثُوا الْعِلْمِ فَمَنْ أَخَذَ أَخَذَ بِحَظٍّ وَافِرٍ. They didn't inherit from the prophets money and gold and diamond and silver. That's not what they inherited from them. إِنَّمَا وَرَّثُوا الْعِلْمِ, they inherited from them knowledge. فَمَنْ أَخَذَ بِهِ أَخَذَ بِحَظٍّ وَافِرٍ. And anyone who takes the knowledge from them has truly taken a great large amount of portion. What is it that the Prophet's da'wah was based upon? Look what it was based upon. هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على دين كل ولو كره المشركون. هدى is what? هو الذي أرسل رسوله. Allah sent His messengers and His prophets with what? هدى and دين الحق. What's هدى? العلم النافع. The prophets were calling to knowledge. Based on knowledge is what they were calling the people to. والعمل الصالح, which is دين الحق. Allah also says in another ayah, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. That we send you a messenger to call the people based upon what? Give them glad tidings and warn them, and you call to your Lord with His permission. وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. And what you're using is insight, understanding, comprehension is what you're using. Also Allah says in another ayah, فَلِذَلِكَ فَدْعُ, and with like that, call to your Lord. وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ, and be steadfast upon that which you were commanded. And how can I be steadfast unless I understand what to be steadfast upon? وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ, and don't follow your desires. وَلِذَلِكَ, pay attention. What is desires? Desires is everything that opposes the Kitab and the Sunnah. Sahih? Allah says in the Quran, فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَكَ, if they don't obey you, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّمَا يَتَّبِعُونَ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ, know that they are following their desires. In another ayah Allah says, ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكَ عَلَى شَرِيعَةِ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ فَاتَّبِعْهَا وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. Then if you follow the Quran and the Sunnah upon knowledge, you're not following your desires. And if your da'wah is based upon other than the knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah, what are you calling the people based upon? You're calling them based upon what? Ahwa, desires. Also Allah says in another ayah, أُدْعُ إِلَى سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ, call to you the path of your Lord with wisdom. Wisdom means what? وَضْعُ الشَّيْءِ فِي مَوْضِعِ. Wisdom means to place everything in its right place. And how do you know where to place something unless you have knowledge of it? وَالْمَوْعِظَةِ, reminder. Hey, you can't remind somebody what you don't understand. وَجَادِلْهُمْ, argue. You can only argue based upon what? Knowing what you're arguing for and what you're arguing against. You need to have all of it. Then da'wah has to have knowledge and understanding. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala clarified that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look what Allah made. Who did Allah make the du'at? All of the, was there ever a prophet who came who had no knowledge? Isn't they them who you're following in da'wah? Because Allah said, وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ نَافِلَةً وَكُلَّا جَعَلْنَا صَالِحِينَ وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ, we made them أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا, guiding to our path. Allah is saying we made Ishaq and Yaqub and all of the prophets. What did we make them? A'immah, leaders, role models. What do they do? Yahdu bi amrina, they are guiding to a what? Our path. A da'i, what's he doing? Guiding the people to whose path? He's guiding the people to who? To Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's path. He has to be based, it all has to be based upon what? Knowledge. Also Allah says in another ayah, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. A scholar, a da'i is a leader, right? Is he not a leader? He's a leader. Two characteristics are needed from him. What are the two characteristics that are needed from him? Patient and certainty. Certainty is a branch of knowledge. It's a branch of what? It's a branch of knowledge. And Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, in his Sahih, chapter 8, Babun al-ilm qabla al-qawli wal-amal. That knowledge precedes speech and action. And he brought the ayah, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَبَدَأَ بِالْعِلْمِ. And he started with knowledge, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in the ayah. He says, فَعْلَمْ, know that there is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz said a very powerful statement. Ibn Ishaq, Ibn Abi Shayban narrates this in his Musannaf. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he says, مَنْ عَمِلَ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ, anyone who does action without no knowledge, كَانَ مَا يُفْسِدُ أَكْثَرَ مِمَّا يُصْلِحُ. He corrupts more than the benefits that he brings. You see him corrupting more than he brings about any benefits. He actually thinks, like by calling the people to Allah in the way that he's doing it, which is based upon ignorance and no knowledge, what has he done? He's brought more corruption for Islam and the Muslims, and he's more of a problem than he's of any benefit. And he's part of the problem than to be part of the solution. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in another ayah, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask those who know when you have no knowledge. A da'i is no doubt a person who's asked questions. And the people are going to come to him. And Allah said, you're only allowed to ask who? The people who know. The people who know, who have understanding. People are coming back to you and they're going to ask you questions and they're going to refer back to you. And so you have to have knowledge of that which you're going to answer. That which you're going to answer. ولذلك, one of the sad realities that we're facing right now is that we distinguish between a da'i and a alim, or a da'i and a student of knowledge. We say fulan is a da'i and fulan is a student of knowledge, or fulan is a da'i and so and so is a scholar, and we distinguish between them. La, a da'i is what? A da'i and a alim and a faqih and a mujtahid and a qari, all of them used to be one according to the Salaf. Like when these got divided, they became what? Who are they? Who is an alim? And who is a faqih? And who is a mujtahid? And who is a qari? All of these are terms that are used for who? Man alima. Anyone who knows al-kitab wa-sunnah wa-amila bihima. Anyone who knows the kitab and the sunnah and implemented them both, that's the person who is a qari, who is an alim, who is a faqih, who is a mujtahid, who is a da'i. All of those titles are the same. They're synonyms of one another. Like in what happened? They divided them. And so they call a qari a man whose lihya is gone. A man who smokes in between the recitations. A faqih is called a person who's teaching you fiqh theoretically. Lakin he's a musbilul izar. He's a liar. He does riba, but he knows theoretically. So they call him faqih. A mujtahid. A scholar. Terms that are being used very lightly. Now we're going to go to the last chapter, inshallah ta'ala, that we plan to go through, which is al-inhirafatu, the deviations that occur in da'wah. And now these deviation and the astray path, it occurs in the ghaya. Okay? The ultimate goal, which was, how many usul did we mention? Three, right? The ghaya, which is the ultimate goal. And the wasila and the sifatu da'iya, all three of them, inhirafat have entered it. Deviation have fallen into it. Let's start with the inhirafat that have happened in the ghaya, the ultimate goal. And how it's occurred wrong. The first one is da'watul jama'at al-hizbiyyah al-istithkar istikthara min al-atba'i. The da'wat of these groups that we have, such as Hizb al-Tahrir, Ikhwan al-Muslimin, Jama'at al-Tabligh, and these groups. All of these groups are what? Their da'wah, it goes against the da'wah of the Anbiya and the Rusul. In what? In the ghaya, the goal. What is their aim? Their aim is al-istikthar min al-atba'. That's their ultimate goal. How many numbers do we have? Okay, it's grown. This year, we've, mashallah, the numbers have increased. Last year, the numbers were low. This is their ghaya, this is their goal. And so based on that, they say we have succeeded in our da'wah. And if it reduces, we've become destructed in our da'wah. And so they don't understand da'wah except through those lenses. And that's the only way that they understand what da'wah is. They have no ultimate goal of teaching the people at-tawheed and the sunnah and aqeedah sahiha. No goal in that. They have no goal. So the person will stay with them for so many years and he will never know the Quran. He will never know the sunnah. He will never know nothing. And if you think I'm lying, then go see those people who are with them. Ask them the Quran. Have they studied the Quran? Do they know it? The sign to know that a person's da'wah is correct according to them is the one who follows the jadwal, the timetable that they set, the schedules that they put together, if anybody follows that. And if a person doesn't follow it, then he's what? He's not multazim anymore. He's not upon istiqamah, he's not upright anymore. There's something wrong with his, he's taking a different approach. And that person might be going to the halaqat, he might be going to circles of knowledge, and that person might be learning, memorizing mutun. Rather, some of them will say to them, akhi, don't learn. What are you learning for? Leave it. And they will stop the person from learning. Also, making maqasid dunyawiyah, worldly gain. The da'wah has only become for them what? Jam'ul amwal, how much money do we have? Why haven't we raised enough money? The donors are giving us, that's what it is. Siyasa, politics. Their da'wah is based upon what? Politics and siyasa. That's maqasid siyasiya they have. As for al-ilm wa ta'aleem, learning and studying and understanding is a amr which is thanawi, secondary issue. Or even, we don't really, even really care about it. Mm-hmm. Some of them, their da'wah is what? It's al-qasiratu ala tahqiq husn al-akhlaq wa suluk wa fada'il a'mal wa ta'abud wa zuhdu fi dunya. Their da'wah is qasir, is restricted to what? Husn al-akhlaq. This person's good etiquette, Allah barik. This person's, mashallah, he prays nawafil, voluntary prayers. It's restricted to that. This person has what? A ta'abbud. You know, he's got these ta'abbudat. And his zuhud fi dunya. He's aesthetic from this dunya. That's what their da'wah is based upon. So what do you find with their mist? Sufiya and tabligh and whatnot, huh? With them. Because that's what the da'wah tabligh is. That's the da'wah of the sufiya. That's what it's all about. And what I said is, their da'wah is qasira. It's restricted to this. That doesn't mean the da'wah shouldn't be part of the da'wah. It is. But this is what it's restricted to. That's all they talk about. When you meet your brother, smile in his face, and wama ila dhalik, things like that. Things that if anybody sits in that crowd and anybody who's with them, never leaves them. Wali dhalika, that's why you find ikhwan al-muslimin within, under their umbrella and under their wing, what do you find? All of the tawa'if, all of the groups, because the things that they talk about are aam, very generic things. Things that, from the rafida being the worst of them, and the other side of the ahlul bid'ah, whichever it may be, from that, everybody would agree. Who wouldn't want khuluq, tayyib, akhlaq, be kind, be generous, wama ila dhalik. And like that. So, qillatul ilm. This knowledge is very left behind. And the ultimate goal being tawheed shouldn't be spoken about. Why? Because tawheed will get rid of tabligh. Tawheed will get rid of them. Sufiyah, this will get rid of them. So the group will become divided. The people will not be as they were. Is it within that divide? Tawheed will clear out who is upon worshipping Allah alone and who isn't. So that's not good for them. That's not good. The second thing in hirafat happens in the wasila, the methodology in which the da'wah is done. The maslak is maslak siyasi. Maslak siyasi means what? It's a political methodology that's taken. Which is what? As-sira'u lil-wusul ila al-hukmi. We Muslims should just focus on bringing leadership back. And that's the rectification of the problem that we have right now. Stop talking about la ilaha illallah, what it means. Stop talking about any other act. We need to just talk about al-wusulu ila al-hukmi, reading leadership. So the approach that they take within themselves are different. They take different approach. One of them is like ISIS and the likes of them. The way they take is urf and shidda and killing and murdering. That's their path, al-wusul ila al-hukmi. That's the way that they take. And then you have the other path which they say, no, listen, if you can't beat them, join their methodology, which is be a political candidate. Go into the MP, get elected, get chosen, and you see them. Wallahi, you see so much of these du'at, and remember this statement, inshallah, you're going to see so much of these du'at becoming senators, becoming member of parliament, and even working towards becoming prime ministers. Hakada. So that's their methodology. That's the path in which they take. So you will never ever find them talking about La ilaha illallah, what it means. That's not part of it. And taking the prophetic methodology in da'wah. They won't take that. The third, some of them will take musical methods, for example. The wasila is what? Anashid. All day music and what more, what not. Now I even heard, subhanAllah, some of them are doing da'wah through, some women are doing da'wah through YouTube makeup. So they say, when I put my makeup on, in between the makeup and what I'm saying, I throw a little ayah and hadith for the people, hakada. She's also doing da'wah. She's also what? She believes that she's doing da'wah in this makeup. That she's, barakallahu feek. Because the path of da'wah is what? Another one, his da'wah is based upon qasas, stories, and al-wa'adiyya. All he does is, all day talks about stories that are made up. And what were the salaf upon when it came to stories? Look at Khabbab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Inna bani Israel lamma halaku, when bani Israel were destroyed, qassu. They became storytellers. Ibn al-Jawzi explains what that means. He says, Inna ma waqa' al-dhamu li ha'ulai. The reason why Allah rebuked those people is because لِأَنَّهُمْ تَرَكُوا كِتَابَ اللَّهِ, they left the book of Allah. وَاشْتَغَلُوا بِالْقِصَصِ عَنْهُ, and they chose stories over it. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ. Abi Abdurrahman al-Sulami, what did he say? أَنَّ عَلِيَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ رَأَى رَجُلًا يَقُصُّ. Abi Abdurrahman al-Sulami, he said, Ali ibn Abi Talib is a man just sitting down telling people stories. He believed by telling stories, he's doing a da'wah. And so look what he said to him. He said to him, عَلِمْتَ النَّاسِخَ وَالْمَنْسُخَ. Do you know the abrogated verses from that which is not abrogated? Look at the Sahabas, they understood that da'wah has to be based on knowledge. And then he said to him, La, I don't know it. And he said, Halakta, you're destroyed. Wa ahlakta, you're destroying the people. Allahu Akbar. Fiqh al-Sahaba, right? You don't know nasikh al-mansukh, you haven't studied that? So what is Ali ibn Abi Talib's usul al-fiqh? Basic. He saw that to be basic. That you don't know nasikh al-mansukh. You don't know it. So what you need to know is, Halakta wa ahlakta. You're destroying yourself and you're destroying the people who are with you. Abdullah ibn Umar, he said, لم يقص زمان أبي بكر لم يقص زمان أبي بكر ولا عمر. The time of Abu Bakr and Umar, no one was telling stories. Abdullah ibn Umar is saying this. إنما كان القصص زمن الفتنة. The time of fitna, storytelling started. ولذلك ابن الجوزي has a كتاب called what? كتاب القصاص والمذكرين. He has a book. أبو إدريس الخولاني, what did he say? لأن أرى في طائفة المسجد النار تتقيد أحب إلي من أن أرى فيها رجلا يقص ليس بفقين. For me to see in the masjid, it burning from one side of the masjid, burning, it's lit and the masjid is burning down, is more beloved to me than to see in the masjid a man who doesn't know fiqh telling people stories. Who say this? Abu Idris al-Khawlani rahimahullah. And Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, what did he say about the qussas? He says, I didn't write the qawl of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. One of the other characteristics that have become the third point, which is al-inhirafat fi sifati da'iyya, deviation and corruption that have occurred in what? In the characteristics of the du'at. Su'un niyya. The person has bad intention. And qasad, his intention and his motives are very bad. He just wants to receive bitahsil al-masalih wal-makasib min khilal da'wat or shuhra. Fame is what he's looking for. Every time he just talks about things which are matters which are it's the most spoken about thing, and so he wants to speak about it now. Why? So he can get shuhra from it, fame from it. That's what he wants. Masalih and makasib, he wants to get money and finance from this, and that's what his purpose behind it, all of this is. So his intention is not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All he does from his da'wah and what he wants from it is a shuhra, name, reputation. Some of them would even meet you and they'll give you salams. And when you say salam alaikum, wa alaikum salam, he'll say to you, akhi, you know me, but I don't know you. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. One of them, even two brothers, were not giving each other salams. And guess why they weren't giving salams? He knows me, why doesn't he give me salams? And the other one said, he knows me, why doesn't he give me salams? I'm famous, I'm known by everybody. Why is he choosing not to give me salams? And the one said, why is he not giving me salams? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So the person becomes ghurur and falls into them. It enters them. Fame and reputation liking. The person's niyyah and the qasad is what? Atba', and this is what happens to the person. It destroys them, right? How many people are viewing my videos? How many people are watching me? How many people are all of that? One of the problems is that the da'wah has, one of the characteristics that are missing is no knowledge. The people who are running the da'wah are ghayrul ulama, they're not the scholars. And not only that, the ones who are running are not ulama and they're not consulting the ulama. So they're destroying more than that they're benefiting. If you look at the people giving da'wah, they are not people of knowledge. So not, they're not learning and they're telling people don't learn. And that wasn't that a characteristics in the ayah? Was it not a characteristics that was mentioned in the ayah? أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة. I call to Allah with insight and knowledge. So they don't learn, they have no knowledge. Not only that, the ones who have knowledge, they don't go back to them. And the third one is, they warn the people from going to them. They warn the people and they say, don't go back to these ulama, they don't know our waqi' and wama ila dhalik, statements like that. So this is the greatest type of deviation that falls in, that occurs. So then what happens? It leaves the atmosphere for them. What does it do? It leaves the atmosphere for them. And so what they do is, based on that, they speak about what they want. And they leave off what they want. And corruptions come from that. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to conclude there bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.